this paper is included with a more global project, and we are developing it progressively. So it is a collaboration between the University of Algeria, the University of Sousse, and some people from France. The outline of the presentation about handicapped women projects, the approach, the ontology that you are developing, the implementation, and finally you conclude and apply some future works. So, about the project, this project is intended to solve handicapped women problems because these women are living in inland places. They haven't much means to improve their works, and they don't use ICT technology, for improving their business. So, and moreover, the policy of governments are not intended for those inland women, but they are intended for developing most coast towns, etc. And this category of women can't improve their business. So we have some objectives within this project. We have to study first the manner handicapped women use technologies to help them enhance it, to use this technology for example, making easier their activities, to empowering their purchasing power, for enhancing their emancipation. And so we have planned to propose them specific training programs, maybe motivating programs, conducted with the social workers, educators, etc. And we have to collect results and analyze those results for enhancing the process. Okay. And finally, we would like to answer the following question. Are current communication technologies suitable to a wide population, or they are intended for only very small category of people? So we have the results of some interviews conducted within a small population of women, and we have concluded that the ICT usage within touristic cities is more important than within rural regions, and we concluded also that phone is best more used than, for example, social networks. Women in mountain regions don't, especially illiterate, don't use a lot of technologies. They use maybe the phone much more. And within the touristic regions, the picture is very different. So we have proposed some learning goals to achieve some business goals. So we have to do some mappings between learning goals and business goals, and to propose some solutions, maybe learning solution, motivating solution, etc. So, for example, for the business goal purchase raw material, the handicapped women should learn how to write and read, should learn how to use telephone, and to achieve this learning goal, we could, for example, make some classroom collaboration or multimedia illustrations. So here we have the pedagogical strategy that we should use for achieving those learning goals. here is our approach, and we have designed some business processes for achieving this solution. And the first business process is conducted by Sun Chikol, sociologist, social worker, and association members. They prepare a list of questions and determine a list of persons to interview. The handicraft woman will answer the questions and collect the information. After collecting that information, we determine a social profile. We have a pattern for social profile, and for that pattern, we can launch some motivation program, determine an individual training strategy, propose, for example, a professional advisor, launch rendezvous to meet women that are living in the same region, etc. And maybe we have to deploy some consultation means to allow the group of women to come and meet the sociologist or the social worker. And here we have the handicapped women A and B that are attending some training programs. So the first step of the program is to welcome learner individually, then to welcome them in groups. Then we start theoretical training, maybe practical training too. And we analyze individual behavior. And for each individual behavior, we will decide which program or strategy program to define or to adapt. And to update the profile and skills after the program, after conducting the program. So to implement this process, we have based our work to in some segmented web service frameworks because we have many data to collect, to analyze, etc. And we have many processes to conduct. So we have based our work on ontologies and on web services to execute those processes. The implemented ontologies. The first one is the context ontology, and this is the main contribution of the work. This context ontology is mainly oriented to collecting the social profile. We have to identify exactly the social profile of each woman, her skills, her community profile, groups and family, maybe social gaps, etc. So this context model will be the driver to all the remaining process. The second ontology concerns the training means, which is connected to the structural entity, which is an entity within the context. And the training mean can be the device, the social mean, or the professional mean. We can, for example, offer a pedagogical tool, or a software, or a pedagogical content. For example, if the group of women can't afford transportation means to go where to have the process, we can offer a means of conveyance, and we can also offer human resources as sociologists, computer scientists, etc. Here is the social-based education ontology, and the social-based education ontology will be based on training means, on motivation program, on a training strategy, and on the social pattern, which is important identity. To implement our solution, we have used a framework called the Web Service Modeling Ontology, and here is the profile ontology implementation, and with this ontology we have implemented the concepts and some actions, and we have enriched this ontology by instances. So instances concern all data collected from people. And this is the action, an example of logical expression, where we define a social pattern by, for example, the social pattern one concerns women who has a certain profile, who has a certain religion, who has a certain sex, and which is a member of an entity actor. Another action concerns the fitted training program, which is intended to a certain learner profile with certain skills, so has learner profile in his value, and this fitted training program will be a training program already stored in the ontology. So we can also infer some social patterns. For example, here we have inferred that Habiba, this handicapped woman, has a profile named Habiba profile. Her name is Habiba, and he is Muslim. And we have that we conclude that we have two women with almost the same